Hello, welcome to Fungi Co headquarters. Here at Fungi Co headquarters, it is the end of winter, and we have Nameko harvests. This harvest is quite mature, this little cluster of Nameko, and I'm going to dry the caps to preserve for later use. The reason why I'm not using the stems is because they can be a little bit tough when reconstituted. Nameko, when they're mature, grow out into a kind of rumply floralet shape, and they sort of lose their sticky caps from when they're younger and have more of a kind of dark brown, sort of bit of a coating on top of their golden brown caps. Nameko have a strong flavour that reminds me of pork or chicken, and also a touch of nutmeg. I like to use Nameko in rich meat dishes like stroganoffs, and also with creamy sauces and gnocchi. I'm going to snip the caps off and just place them on my baking paper on a baking tray and put the caps under a windowsill, and in a few days they should be quite dry. I'll show you a large mushroom. And Nameko have a thick stem that has a bit of a shaggy appearance. They have a golden brown cap. There it goes. I'm just going to snip them from the cluster like that. Scissors are fine. Mushrooms are very soft-bodied organisms. Scissors are great. I can retain the stems for using in dye making, so they can be dried separately and used later as well. I like to dye walls with Nameko. It gives a pretty yellow colour to wool. Snipped off the cluster. I'll lay these out. Blup, 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 blup. So spread them out a little bit. And